the kingdom of God. Now, as we continue, we're about to seal our prayer. We now say, thine kingdom, thy power, and thy glory. Meaning, what we are praying for is the kingdom of God. For the kingdom of God is in the spiritual realm. It is yet only created in the minds of people that are God-fearing. It is the people of God that are carrying the kingdom of God in them. For they are carrying the kingdom of God in their minds, in their hearts, and in their hands as they work. For the kingdom of God is exalted in the kindness of the children of God, in the giving of the children, in the wisdom of the children of God. That is when we see the kingdom of God. Now we acknowledge, for the word of God says in the book of Proverbs chapter 1 verse 7, the fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge and wisdom, but fools despise wisdom and instructions. See, now that you've got people who pray to God, now we've got people who can, attain to the spiritual realm, we are now in the kingdom of God. Since we are in the kingdom of God in prayer, we need to acknowledge the power. The power of God is not in retaliation. The power of God is not in being aggressive. The power of God is in submission. When we submit in prayer, we humble ourselves in prayer, we are showing that we are in the kingdom of God. Then guess what? Inasmuch as people are given crowns and rewards, one thing that we are being promised is the glory of God. Those who understand the glory of God is that there is the glory of the Father, the glory of the Son, and the glory of the angels, of which Jesus Christ is going to come with. That is going to embrace the whole kingdom of God. So the kingdom of God is found in the people of God who are humble, but it is in the spiritual realm. The spiritual realms and the spiritual things can only be accessed through prayer. Prayer is the key that unlocks the things in the spiritual realm. Prayer is the key that can also take us to the kingdom of God. For the kingdom of God is full of power. Our God is a victorious God. Our God goes to war as a conqueror. He doesn't go to war as a victim. He goes as a victor. For when we pray to God in submission, in humbleness, we are showing God that, God, we know that your kingdom is powerful, but you don't have to reveal and show off with your power. When we humble, yet we are so mighty, we're showing people that our God can still humble himself and save those who think that they are beyond repair. For when we pray to God and we say, let thy kingdom come, we are saying, help us, Lord, to be influential to the next person. When we are saying, God, let thy kingdom come, we are saying, God, help us to see the things that other people cannot see. May God bless you as we invite the kingdom of God and you stay in the presence of the Lord in prayer. Amen.